Fadi, does IMX also obsess about data? I mean, it's a web company, so obviously it's easy to capture the data. In IMX, bricks and mortar company?
Yeah, absolutely, totally. I mean, there is, all companies are bricks and clicks now. So, I mean, we have a lot of bricks, but anybody can have bricks. It's about the data, it's about the knowledge, it's about what you do with that data, how you analyze it, how do you use it. And the more you, I mean, there's no way out of that. So absolutely, everything. Everything is measured, everything is analyzed, everything has to be analyzed. I mean, because if he needs it, then I have to have it. So it's, I mean, there's no question about that.
Another question?
Yeah, we have one back here.
I have a question for Fadi. What does climate change mean to you, your business, and what should it mean to startups?
So climate change as in climate change?
Not as in the seasons, as in the change of climate change.
Yes, so we are a massive polluter, as you know, meaning the logistics industry. So we run trucks, we run aircrafts, we ruin the climate. It's a big issue for the industry. For us at RMX, as you know, we were the first, again, a bit of a sales pitch, we were the first company to have ever issued a sustainability report with clear metrics of deliverables. So we know exactly where we, and we have finally come out with a report recently on a per package basis, our carbon footprint. So we are able to tell you now, if you send a package, how much are you contributing to the destruction of the environment? Because it's a partnership, it's your package. I'm carrying it for you, but you're the one responsible for the damage. and we all have to continue to ship packages. So yes, we know it. So the issue is, it's not about climate only. It's about social consciousness inside the organization. So in all its aspects.
How important do you think that is for startups as well in terms of having
You have to. It's in today's world. I'll tell you, we're bidding on businesses today that tell us and ask us specifically for details on our position on sustainability in every single sense of the word, from carbon footprint, all the way about on how we train our employees, how do we on bribery issues, on every single aspect that you think doesn't matter. And they will bring their compliance team into your organization and tell you, you want to bid on this business, you'd better publish, you'd better be transparent, and you'd better do that on a regular basis and share it with us. So startups, it's not a luxury. It is a necessity that you might not feel it in the beginning. But the minute you touch a client that cares, he is going to, and a lot of clients do, so they won't do business with you. Multinationals that are forced in their marketplaces. So there is no regulatory process in some markets here. So you have to self-regulate, because if you're going to do business with multinationals who come to these markets, they have to adhere legally in their marketplaces to certain standards, which means they bring their habits and their rules and regulations with them into your marketplace. So effectively, there is a virtual globalization of the awareness and the compliance of it's not only a global treaties only. It is actually downright to the minute relationship with your clients.
Just a quick question to follow up. Fadi, would you advise to compromise profitability to contribute to sustainability in this manner?
I'm the wrong person to ask that question now. So I would say it is not compromising on profitability. It is part and parcel of your cost. It is actually cheating the system if you're not able to plug in the cost of whatever you're doing that is socially irresponsible. If you are socially irresponsible, your balance sheet has something wrong with it, and I have to worry about it, because eventually it will come back to bite you and the cost will come back to you. If you don't pay it on the front end, you'll pay it at the back end. So eventually it is coming. So you either integrate it in your system from day one and it is part and parcel of your investment thinking, or you're going to have a problem of sustainability at the end of the day. So it's not a question of compromising on profit. It is viewing profit differently.
Thank you. And also, I guess it boils down to values, like Google says, do no evil, kind of like at the beginning. Another question from the crowd?
You're talking about responsibility because of, let's say, insurance investment or client consciousness. Is the fact that Aramex have been has always been a pioneer in responsibility in the region, has this helped Aramex somehow in terms of marketing or attracting talents?
Big time. Look, viewing sustainability and environmental consciousness and values from a holistic perspective, meaning you might compromise somewhere on your profitability in terms of your financial returns. Maybe. I mean, I don't know. It will always come back to you. It's an investment. So attracting talent, talented people today will not come to companies that are not sustainable. They will not. And I'm talking about the best of the best here. They, if you don't have the proper corporate culture, and if you don't have the organization that is in its values system sustainable, and aware of the social issues, you will lose that talent. They might come in early on and they find you not doing it, you will lose them. So attracting talent, having to do it from the perspective of actually delivering your services to your clients who are demanding it today, to actual shareholders that today are gonna tell you, I'll tell you, in Aramex we have one global fund that invests in us, and they invest in us because we issue a sustainability report. And one of their criteria of investing in emerging markets is that the company has to publish a sustainability report, otherwise they won't own our stock. And you have a trend in that. You have a trend in that. And there is post-crash of 2008, it's even becoming much more of a trend. It used to be that the old story of business is only business, and Milton Friedman telling you, you know, companies have to pay their taxes and employ people and that's their social responsibility, does not work anymore. Because I cannot pollute and maximize profits at the same time. Because if you pollute, then there is a huge cost that is not on your balance sheet and it effectively kills you. So the banks who collapsed in 2008 were maximizing profit. Their managers were making hundreds of millions of dollars in profitability. They had on the front end a good return for their shareholders. But what happened to them today? Where are they? What did they do to the global marketplace? They affected people in China. They affected people in Dubai. They affected people everywhere. So there is a global impact to the value system of an organization that we are told is too big to fail. Because it eventually fails and brings us all down with it. So the question of social consciousness has to be built into any business, and startups have to do the same thing. So it's, if you think it's a luxury, then you are building your business on the wrong footing.
Thank you.